Once you collect and package the biocontrol agents, maintain them at temperatures between 50 and 65 degrees Fahrenheit. If possible, place the release containers in large coolers equipped with frozen ice packs. Don't use ice cubes unless they're contained in a separate, closed, and leak-proof container. Wrap the ice packs in crumpled newspaper to prevent direct contact with release containers and to absorb any condensation that forms. Then place extra packing material in the coolers to prevent ice packs from moving around and damaging the biocontrol agent containers. As an alternative to coolers with ice packs, electric car charge coolers may be utilized. Always keep coolers out of direct sun and only open them when you're ready to release the biocontrol agents. If you can't release them immediately, place them in a fridge no lower than 40 degrees Fahrenheit for short-term storage until you transport or ship them, which should occur as soon as possible and preferably not longer than 48 hours. If you'll be shipping your biocontrol agents to their final destination, use a bonded carrier service with guaranteed overnight delivery and make sure that they can accept this type of cargo and will not treat the packages in ways that could harm the biological control agents. Plan collection and packaging schedules so that overnight shipments can be made early in the week. Avoid late week shipments that may result in delivery on Friday through Sunday, potentially delaying release of the biocontrol agents for several days. Send the recipient the tracking number for the package. Verify that someone will be there to accept the shipment and instruct them to open the package and place the release containers directly into a refrigerator until the biocontrol agents can be released, as soon after receipt as possible. The release containers should be placed in insulated shipping containers with one or more ice packs. Some specially designed foam shippers have pre-cut slots to hold small biocontrol agents and ice packs. This construction allows cool air to circulate but prevents direct contact between the ice and the release containers. Laboratory and medical suppliers sell foam bio-shippers that are used to transport medical specimens or frozen foods. If neither foam product is available, you can use a heavy-duty plastic cooler, which also may be better suited to large weed stems infected or infested with biocontrol agents. For safety reasons, dry ice cannot be used for transporting biocontrol agents. Careful packaging is very important, regardless of the shipping container you use. Ice packs need to be wrapped in crumpled newspaper, wrapping paper, or bubble wrap, and should be firmly taped to the inside walls of the shipping container to prevent them from bumping against and possibly crushing the release containers during shipping. Empty spaces in the shipping container should be loosely filled with crumpled or shredded paper, bubble wrap, packing peanuts, or other soft insulating material. Use enough insulation to prevent release containers and ice packs from shifting during shipment, but not so much that air movement is restricted. In the USA, transporting many biocontrol agents across state lines requires a special permit. If your shipment is going interstate, enclose all paperwork accompanying the biocontrol agents, including copies of permits and release forms, before sealing the shipping container. For additional security and protection, you may place the sealed shipping containers or coolers inside cardboard boxes. Clearly label the shipping containers and specify that they contain perishable material.